Welcome to your practice. Please, please try to settle into a posture that promotes stillness. You could even be moving in your body. We're after stillness of mind somewhat. But really, we're after discovering the timeless stillness that never goes away. And it impacts the mind and body. So if the mind is moving, the body is moving, there's still this clarity that informs the mind, the body. It informs the whole world. It informs how you perceive. It is the origin of perception. It is the beginning of existence. Gary used to emphasize paying attention right when you first wake up, right as the world, your sense of self, and your thoughts kick online. Right at that first moment, you can just be with this origin, this timeless stillness. It happens quick. It gets going quick. But the timeless stillness is always there. It's just sort of isolated, or everything else is quieter in that first moment at waking. As we accumulate experience and then memory, it can become easy to forget the timeless stillness. But it is nevertheless wrapped around and woven through all of our sense perception, all of our thinking mind. And we know it already. Sometimes we think of enlightenment as some goal or destination. And that can be a little unfair, I think, to the aspirant, to the seeker. But for us tonight, rather, just sit in it. Feel that you know it already. Believe it. Believe in your worth. Believe in your value. Believe that it is already achieved. That it's obvious. It's special, but it's not unique. The body and the mind, that's unique. But the timeless stillness, it's abundant, readily available. It's the foundation, origin of perceptions, experience. So whatever you are experiencing, sound of these words, your own thoughts, body sensations, connect the knowledge that they would not be possible without you, without the knower of these things. You know the body. You know the thoughts. You know the world. You know that there is a world that you don't know about. You could know nothing about it without you. You can only appreciate it, your life, because of you. You are the timeless stillness. Timeless, because you know of time. You would know nothing of time without you. Stillness, because it's the only thing that's not moving. Even though your body might be not moving, it's not really. It's moving. Pulsing. Everything you know is moving. You are the immovable. And so this is how you come to know. The body, the personality, your likes and dislikes. They move through timeless stillness. Try it. Try to treat these things that are moving through the timeless stillness endearingly, like a beloved. You treat your mind, your body, the world. Treat your breath, your emotions. Endearingly, look upon them not as obstacles, but as companions. Treasures. Wonders. Gifts. But not possessions. We do not need to cling to them. They have come into perception perception emerged out of timeless stillness. Enjoy what is here now. How to enjoy it? How do we appreciate this precious life? You do not need to intensify your senses. You do not need to get more of anything. No reaching, no grasping. This world is flooding into the moment. Crashing into this moment. You can't get away. It is here already. To enjoy is to recognize. To see it as it is. You can see thoughts in the mind. You can see sights with the eyes. You can hear thoughts in your mind, and you can hear the sounds of the world. Taste, touch. There's a mental world and a physical one. But all of it is inside you, the timeless stillness. Do you need more to feel in this moment? There is so much already. But you don't really need less either. to just feel what is. Right now, whatever's there, right now. To really feel it. You will move through the world of separation. You will perceive its truth. You will come to know the timeless stillness. Because where could it go? Savor, appreciate, enjoy anything, everything that's passing through the body, the mind, the person, the world. The objects in the world are passing through timeless stillness. Each one of them is a mirror back to the timeless stillness. You just need look. You just need see. Your presence is unavoidable, inescapable. And when you see yourself as the most valuable thing in all existence, then we cherish existence. Then we can lovingly relate. Anyone, anything, any circumstance. Once you let yourself know what is already knowable, what your senses are already sensing, what your thoughts are already thinking, feeling. Once you harmonize, synchronize with this moment of perception, doors open to what was unknown. Your relation grows deeper to what is knowable. Let it happen. Let reality pour out of timeless stillness. Place yourself at the font, at the origin. lovingly, joyfully. Appreciate even the sorrow. They are visitors, guests. Everything that enters, perception. Perception itself is just a visitor in timeless presence, timeless stillness. Let them offer their gifts of wisdom. Let them reflect back to you who you are, how important you must be, that they have come to see you. Even pain. Maharaj says, pain is just the body's recognition that something needs attention. Relax from the practice.